So we don't have a compere to introduce ourselves.
Shall I compere me?
You're quite good at that. Come in.
A great big applause for show of hands.
Come on, tell me, won't you?
songs. This is to all our friends in the Long Dogs crowd. Going back years and years now, selling raffles for us, catering for us backstage. What won't be to ask? Red brick cottage on the edge of the woods, cars and cages all around. In the back, in the lean-to shed, that's where my long dogs found. Got a four-wheel pickup and a shotgun. Never bought a meal in my life. I go shopping with a lamp and a knife. I've got a long dog. I am a poacher. I'm working in the fields one night. On another man's land, those boys in blue, they watch me leave, a sack full of rabbits in hand. Early next day, they follow me down to a shop in the middle of the square. So the brace of pheasants are everywhere. I'm not, I am a poacher. You know, there's only one thing that a poor man needs, a lean and a long dog built for speed. I was in the woods of the town JP, County Court, they didn't agree. We had a long dog, got a poacher. Most of him you can consume. As for Nigella, oh, now you're talking. I said, go, game boy. Thank you very much. I suppose this song really should be sung with Tom's Risky Business. It's a song we were lucky enough to play on the Andrew Marr show about 8 years ago. And William Hague was there listening attentively. Called AIG. And it was a song, you know, you imagine would have a shelf life of literally 6 months when it was written in 2008, 2009. All about the bonus culture and all that sort of stuff. Going on up there, is that the Montes? There you go. AIG, Arrogance, Ignorance and Greed. What a great acronym. Sure, starting to think of one for FIFA, but that's early days, yeah.
That's very on stage.
Of course, the World Cup getting awarded to Qatar, there was no money changed hands for that. You know, it's the home of football, after all. It's like, Jesus Christ, free fire! Somewhere I could call my own. Some tracks in the background playing from the new record, which is out in September, featuring the wonderful Cormac Byrne. We're touring with Cormac and with Miranda in the autumn. Really looking forward to that. But Cormac is, he's very Irish, is Cormac. He says, ah, Jesus, Phil, I'm looking at you there, look like a big pint of Guinness.
But only in the evenings.
And he really does say Philum. So we're looking forward to that. Have you bought tickets?
Good.
Someone's coming to Yeovil already.
No, don't make me go to Yeovil.
So about 6 years ago, wonderful Mark Radcliffe and Stuart McConey were broadcasting from Beer, just down the coastline. I'm having a beer in Beer with Phil Beer. And we were asked to play a song on Radio 2, literally, different. It wasn't the folk show, it was the usual sort of evening audience. So we thought we'd reinvent a well-known American rock and roll song and relocate it to Branscombe or somewhere similar like that. You may have recall the original of this. Goes like this. Mm-hmm.
reach. Empty lake, empty street, sun goes down alone. I'm driving by your house, though I know you're not home, and I can see it, brown skin shining in the sun. Got your hair swept back in the rain.
A song located on the wild and mysterious island of Portland. I wanted a location for a bleak, sad love song where desolation and sex walk the street. Chard was busy, so I chose Portland. Song about jealousy and misplaced faith. It's called My Old Man's a Dustman.
Dustman, and where's
of sea and stone. There are no trees on the island, nowhere to shelter or hide. Men tear rock from the quarry to take their chances on the tide. Sets the fuse. When I heard the thunder from the earth, it made me choose between falling and my cold, so cold. They used to walk beside the water. Everybody up.
One of the first times we went down there to do a photo shoot, we went to the bit where they chuck out the stones that they break or mess up, and have a go stonemasons are allowed to go down there at the weekend and try and make things. So it's like a sort of escape from a horror film with all kinds of grotesque sort of things, people attempting to fashion them out of stone. And we found one particularly wonderful thing. Someone had obviously spent months trying to make the frame of a church window, you know, stained glass window. And they got pretty damn close to it, but they must have hit the bottom right-hand corner too hard, and it had broken off. It's a bit sad, really, isn't it? You go to all that work to make that. However, undeterred, what they'd actually done was they'd got their etching chisel, and across what was left of the bottom lintel, they tried to practice their lettering. So they wrote, "Oh, bollocks."
Speaketh the Lord. Deuteronomy. Due to incompetence. So listen, Phil and I, unlike Miranda here, who was born into a folky family, possibly conceived at Sinbad Festival or something close, we weren't like that. We discovered this music when we were in our teens. So we're quite good at stealing genres. And this is a brand new genre off the new album too. This is Cornish reggae. It's called Dreckley. And we've checked with the boys from E2, and it is authentically Jamaican. Yeah, I'll come back directly, man. And directly is Cornish for manana. And it's a song all about a young man. He lives in Swindon, and he's got a Cornish girlfriend, and he's finding it hard to persuade her to stay in Swindon for some reason. Then she sees the fisherman's friend, Phil, and then she's off. She's across the Tamar. So he's determined to track her down and to get her to come back to Wiltshire. And whether or not he succeeds, you'll find out in this next song. And when we were travelling around with Richard Schindel, so I don't know if any of you saw the tour with Richard. Richard is a fine American, one of the best. You know, he's a man of the world. But he couldn't quite cope with some of the things that are tearing us apart in this country. Families haven't spoken. Brothers and sisters aren't talking, you know. Parents aren't talking to their kids. And the big issue is whether you put the cream on first or the jam on your scones. So I think tonight it's time to resolve that once and for all. So I'm going to ask you to elect your choice of cream or jam first. And the biggest cheer gets it. And this is not going to be a people's vote. Once we've voted, this is it. It's compulsory, right? So I'm going to ask you if you want jam on first and you cheer, and then cream on first. So first of all, on your warm scone, if you want jam first, cheer. If you want cream on first, cheer. Yay! Whoa. Cream it is. Excellent. Good choice. It's obvious, isn't it? Anything else is heresy. No pilchard, no cry. Or no pasty, no cry. Bags are in the hole. Your car is waiting in the street. Nah. Why don't you tell me where you're gonna stay? Way past midnight, still you don't call. I don't know if we're sour or sweet, but I'm not gonna pace the floor till the break of day. No smoke without fire. Track you down. Maybe I've been misled. I gotta get a green-eyed monster off my chest. You have done it tonight. No smoke without fire. No light without heat. No trip without a wire. No heart without a beat. I'm out here howling at the Tamar. Don't make me sing. Decided to include a song by the late, great Leonard Cohen on the new record. It's one that we've known a while, called First They Take Manhattan, and we've known it as Berlin. It's an extraordinary song, all about... It's sort of got all these Cold War images. I suppose it was written in the 70s or the 80s, maybe even earlier than that. And people like Smiley's people were behind the scenes. And we were playing it in Salisbury on the last tour. And it only occurred to me when we were in Salisbury how much times have changed. It's not grey men in suits who sort of have an understanding of each other. It's guys in bomber jackets grinning through the streets as they scatter enough poison to kill a whole school full of kids. And then they go back home and get medals and rewards. So things have changed. Things are so much more brutal. But the song still has a nice edge to it. First, we take Manhattan. They sentence me to 20 years of boredom to try and change the system from within. fashion business, mister. Festival set together, and usually the last thing people want to hear is a bunch of new songs. You know. You try and chuck them in, you try and sort of like go, and then there's a little dip. This is that little dip in the middle, and when we sort of try and rebuild it again. So it's really time to sort of like do a few shout outs. Chloe Moore, where are you? Where are you, Chloe? How many weeks have you got to go? 2 weeks to go before a baby's born. She's risky this. So we have to cut the bottom end out of the PA system. Baby's there going, get me out. Chloe Moore down there. So give Chloe a round of applause.
Mr. Richard Pugh, once again, it almost corresponds with his birthday. Richard, you won't mind us saying that you're 70. Not today, but yesterday, in fact, isn't it?
I believe,
yes, or have I got it so wrong? Where is he? Mr. Richard Pugh, a lifelong friend of ours, wonderful man, comes every year and helps doing the catering and all that kind of stuff. Happy birthday, Richard.
What I like is Chloe's partner, Derek, was dragged to this gig not being told it was folk.
Luckily, he was right.
I don't like this folk nonsense. Probably doesn't talk like that, actually.
But then neither do we.
No,
we
have to. Many of you know that Phil and I, really, this is the area we began playing in about in the early 90s, and it was nice to find some local folk songs to take around the world.
It was Mr. Gerard O'Farrell who was our original sound engineer and manager. We were getting plenty of gigs, but we weren't getting any festivals. No one was interested. So Gerard said he was a sort of a brusque Australian. He used to come right to the point. He said, right, we'll create 5 open-air events of our own. And this is the one that stuck, basically. We did 5 events dotted around sort of the southern part of the British Isles, and this is the one that absolutely stuck, that captured people's imaginations, and luckily seems to be catching people's imaginations still. Thank you.
This is one of those local folk songs that we've been playing ever since. This is a Blue Cockade. To go and join the orange
Here's a handsome young man, like wiser than blame. Here's a handsome young man, and he's gone to serve the name. Why, oh my fairy, why, oh my fairy, why, oh my fairy,
why,
oh
my fairy.
It's been 25 years or more, I've roamed the land from shore to shore. Time to tame our sevens and tens, more to bail, peat and fen. Played in cafe and pub and bar, stood in the street with my first guitar. But I'd be richer than all the rest if I had a pound for each request. For Julian Banjo's American Pie, it's enough to make you cry. Rule Britannia, swing low. By the only songs the English know. Seed, bud, flower, fruit, we're never gonna grow without our roots. Branch and stem and shoot. What do we need? When the cake's been cut, the disco's over, the bar is shut. Birthday, christening, wedding or wake, what can we sing till the morning breaks? An Indian, Asian, Afro-Celt, it's in the blood below the belt. Singing and dancing all night long, what a ring of right we've got wrong. Seed, bud, flower, fruit, never gonna grow without our roots. Branch, stem, and shoot.
And haul away, boys, let them go. Out in the rain and the wind and snow. We've lost mother and we'll never know. When the rocky shores will make us dry. Haul away, boys, let them go. Out in the wind and the rain and snow. We've lost more than we'll ever know. When the rocky shores will make us dry.
We need rain. Come on. Minister said his vision of hell is three folk singers in a pub near Wells. I got a vision of urban sprawl and pubs where no one ever sings at all. Everyone stares at great big screens. Overpaid soccer star prancing, teen Australian soap, American rap, history, English baseball cap. Let me learn to be ashamed before we walk of the way we look and the way we talk. Without story, without song, how will we know where we've come from? I lost St. George in the Indian Jack, that's my place. Now I want it back. Save one flower fruit. Never gonna grow without their roots. Branch, stem, shoot. We need the roots.
All the way, boys, let them go.
Let's go.
have an amazing crew with us. After tonight's show, Naomi on the sound desk, she's off to London to do Brian Ferry tomorrow. I mean that in a musical sense, not any other. Marcus back there is on lights. This is Craig up here, and Matt, and of course our tour manager Jamie at the backstage, sorting all sorts of things out you would not believe. Can you give all of them a round of applause, please? It's called Exile.
There's a shadow passing over me. Will it stay forevermore? Like wave I'm breaking far at sea. There's no one to hear the roar. All the days are drifting into seasons. They're the longest I have known. Million spaces in the earth to fill, but no That's the kind of the first song we ever did together as Shirt Hens, all way back in 1986 at the Wimbledon Folk Festival. He turned up with a sheaf of songs, which that one I thought was the outstanding one. And we sat down over a beer, and not in beer, but we sat down, had a beer, and decided that we'd do some acoustic stuff. And here we are, doing acoustic stuff.
There's another piece of genre appropriation. This is some Devonian Bangra. About 20 miles away at this very moment is a good friend of ours, Johnny Kelsey and the Dole Foundation. And they do this amazing Bangra sort of Bollywood rhythm on the Dole drum. It's really infectious. And everybody sort of gets into the groove. And Johnny does this thing, he says it in the Punjab. Everybody raises their hands to the heaven, they go, hey, hey. It's always on the offbeat. He says it's the way that they pray for rain. So we're not going to bother with that bit, okay, Tom? But this is the actual, and we played this live with Johnny last December. So, and often the Bangra starts off with a sort of, starts off with one of those rhythms to sort of set the whole thing growing, which is Naomi's favourite ever sound. So, we'll see if we can get that in, I'm not quite sure. So the idea is like a Bangra stroke Morris dance rhythm with a bit of history thrown in. So, and we've got the Agincourt, we have the Armada, so forgive the bit of low-level swearing from Sir Francis Drake in that verse. What he would have made of the Bank of Santander in Plymouth, I do not know. You're the bastard thing. Then we have Waterloo, and finally we have D-Day. So it's all quite topical and trendy. But what we need from you to go is to count down. 1, 2, 3, 4. But it's on the offbeat. Get them up. 1, 2, 3, 4. A bit like 2, 4, 6, 8. Now, I wonder where I got this from. Get them up.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Then I sing another bit, and I sing. Set them up.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Great stuff. 1, 2, 3, 4. Through the damp, soldiers round the campfire singing dirty songs, passing out the aid, and even Henry sings along. Get them up.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Kicking at the dance, watch your hands and feet, the force, set them up.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Tomorrow is a battlefield, tonight it is a dance floor. Drake and all his mates playing balls out on the hoe. The Spanish in the distance have 100 miles to go. Finish off the game, let's wander into town. Buy another round. Get them up.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Kicking at the dance, watch your hands and feet, the floor. Set them up.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Tomorrow is a battlefield, tonight it is a dance floor. We need more hand movement on the chorus. On the offbeat. Wellington in Brussels on the eve of Waterloo. Dancing with the lady like a gentleman should do. Bony in the distance, 30 miles away. Knocking at the brandy till the very break of day. Get them up.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Kicking at the dance, watch your hands and feet, the force. Set them up.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Tomorrow is a battlefield, tonight it's a dance floor. Cigars and a bunch of pretty girls. Tonight we're gonna part, and tomorrow save the world. Get them up.
1, 2, 3.
Kicking at the dance, like a hand, a hand, a hand, a hand.
1, 2, 3, 4.
dance floor. I'm just enjoying. I don't know what I'm enjoying. I'm out of my brains. What does it matter? Anyway.
He hates it.
So we did, all those years ago, we worked with these wonderful Chilean musicians. And we formed a temporary group called Alianza, hence the birth of us playing the cuatro, the one of which was won tonight. And this song came out of that collaboration. It's called Santiago. It'd be lovely if you would sing it with us. And when it comes to the chorus. But I'd forgotten it, so well reminded. From the ports of the west, we sailed into the sun. South America now, our journey begun. Lights going out in the barrios. It was half a world away. We had an ocean to cross and a course to steer all the way. There'll be laughter and song in the barrio. going on to. Martin and all the staff here at Abbotsbury, give them a round of applause, please. And Richard Barnes and the raffle sellers, doing such an amazing job. Backstage, Steve and Terry, Harry Claude, Richard, Nick and Claire for feeding us, looking after us. Nick Oddie for providing a quattro for the raffle. Thank you, Nick. Amazing musicians as well. What about Kelly Watt? Let's hear it for Kelly. Let's hear it for Banter, please. Let's hear it for the wonderful track dogs. And the legendary Tom Robinson. And Lee. Miranda Sykes on the double bass. My name's Steve Knightley, this is Phil Beer. Smoke and distant flames. hate the blood, we crave the meat.
Buy me a beer, I'll take my knife.
Cut you a slice of country life. How does that taste? To heal by a hammer blow of size and scale. Foot and mouth, just another nail in the coffin of an English dream. It lies out there in the village green, where Aquilarans cap in hand, Mr. Barberine and our pleasant man of metal put down their drill pods. What remains they build upon, there's no train, no shops, no pub. Oh, what pubs we used to play. Singing this song. Abbotsbury, on your own, come on. This together, and again Naomi on the sound, and Marcus and all that, all the crew and Craig here. So lots of gigs throughout the autumn near you. This land is barren and broken. Sing it. Sky like the face of the moon. Our tongue is no longer spoken. These towns on a round face ruin. Will there be work? Will there be work in New Brunswick? Or will I find gold in the Cape? I can tunnel way down to Australia, but I may never escape. Here we go.
Where there's a mine or a hole in the ground, that's where
sounds great. Woo! Copper and clay.
Where the copper and clay, where the arsenic and tin run in your blood, they get under your skin. I'm leaving my county. she left no choice. No visions of heaven sustained us, and John Wesley gave us a voice. Did Joseph once come to St. Michael's now?
Thank you.
Thanks a lot, go safely.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah. I got.